Welcome to my project Buzzer. Let's we go to demo of system. The title of the project is Delay Models for Static and Adaptive Persistence Resource Allocations in Wireless System. The abstract of the project is variety of scheduling strategies can be employed in wireless system to satisfy different system objectives and to later for different traffic types. Static persistence resource allocations can be employed to transfer small M2M data packet efficiently compared to dynamic packet by packet scheduling. Even when the M2M traffic model is non-determined, recently adaptive persistence allocations have been proposed in which volume of allocated resource can change in sympathy with the instantaneous queue size at the M2M device and without expensive signaling on control channel. This increases the efficiency of resource usage at the expense of a increased packet delay. In this paper, we draw statistical model for the device queue size and packet delay in a static and adaptive persistence allocations, which can be used for any arrival process. The primary motivation is to assist with dimensioning of persistence given a set of requirements. We validate the statistical model via comparison with queue size and delay statistics obtained from a discrete event simulations of a persistence allocation system. The validation is performed for both exponential and gamma distributed packet inter-arrivals to demonstrate the model. Now we start the demo of this project. This is the form for the delay models for static and adaptive persistence resource allocation in wireless system. Click the enter button. This form contains data source upload form. So click the open file button. Open the file path. I choose the file patient.csv. This is the dataset for patient. And click the load dataset button. This form contains each data is separately name, patient, address, age. So easily understand the user. And click the next button. This form is used for how many records it contains a patient and how many number of rows and how many number of columns in the particular data set. So click the load data set button. View button. This form contains information about data set details. This is the patient data set. Number of records is 50 and the number of rows is 50, number of columns is 7. So click next button. This form contains information about each separately: address, disease and final report. So click the get address button. This is the address for the patient. And next one, click the disease button. The treatment is ongoing. Which treatment is going on to patient? So each treatment is separately in this button. And click the final report button. And finally click the key button. In this form. Click the receive key button. Key is received. And one more, click the receive text button. The encrypted text will be showed. And finally click the decrypt button. This is the decrypted text and store the database. So information is stored in server 1. So server 1 process is over. Next, run the server 2 form. Also click the receive key button. The key is received. And click the receive text button. Or view the encrypted messages and click the decrypted button. So information is decrypted and stored in server 2. Third one is server 3 process. The same process occurs in server 3.